So we will start with the question. Given f of x is equals to modulus x minus a upon x minus a when x is not equal to a, and the value of the function is 1 when x is equals to a, we have to show that this function is discontinuous at x is equals to a. It will be, it is written as 0, it will be a at x is equals to a, right? So the very first step we will be taking, left hand limit. Left hand limit we will be taking f of, at a we will be taking a minus h. Whatever point is given to us, we will subtract a small number h, right? And before that, we will also write limit h is tending to 0. Limit h is tending to 0 negative f of a minus h. This will be left hand limit. Whatever the point is given, we will subtract a small number h from that. Whenever we will subtract h from a number, the number will come on the left of the point. So this will be f of a x is x minus a up modulus upon x minus a. When x will be replaced by a minus h, we will put the value limit h is tending to 0 negative modulus. In place of x, I have a minus h. In place of x, I have a minus h minus a mod of that over x minus a, means in place of x, I am having a minus h minus a. Now I will simplify. So a will be cancelled with a in the numerator as well as in the denominator. So we will be having limit h is tending to 0 negative modulus minus h upon minus h, right? We have done nothing. We are taking left hand limit and right hand limit. For taking left hand limit, we take a small number h and subtract it from the given point so that the value comes on the left side but very near to the point a, and we take it as left hand limit. Now we are solving it. Modulus of limit h tend to 0 negative mod of minus h will return h, and in the denominator it is minus h. H cancelled with h, limit h is tending to 0 negative of minus 1. 0 negative. So of minus 1. Now we will put h, but since minus 1 is independent of h, it will return us the value minus 1. So left hand limit in this case is minus 1. Now we will check right hand limit. Right hand limit, we will be taking a plus h. So it will be limit h is tending to 0 positive f of a plus h. Now we are adding a very small h to a so that whatever the number will be, it will be on the right side of a, but it will be very close to a, and we are taking limit h is tending to 0 positive. So in the given function, in place of x, now we will be writing a plus h. So here x is there, we will be writing a plus h minus a modulus. Over x is there, we will be writing a plus h minus a. And before that, we also have to write limit h is tending to 0 positive. We will solve that. A is cancelled with a. So limit h is tending to 0 positive. This is mod of h upon h. So we will simplify. It will be limit h is tending to 0 positive. Mod of h means h upon h, which is cancelled. So we are limit h is tending to 0 positive. H upon h means 1, which is independent of h. We have to put h is equals to 0, but this value is independent of h. So we will be getting 1. So right hand limit, limit h is tending to 0 positive f of a plus h. Instead of x, we are putting a plus h in the given function. So we will be having modulus a plus h minus a upon a plus h minus a. And limit h is tending to 0 positive. A get cancelled with a, so limit h is tending to 0 positive. We are getting modulus h upon h. Mod h will return h. H upon h will be 1. So we are getting right hand limit 1. Also, the value of the function when x is equals to a, that means f of a is equals to 1. So since left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit, right? And also the left hand limit is not equal to the value of the function. Therefore, we will say that it is only sufficient to prove that left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit. Therefore, the function is discontinuous at x is equals to a. So everywhere we are following same rule. We are finding left hand limit. We are finding right hand limit. If value of the function is given, then it is fine. If it is not given, then we will calculate it by putting the point. If it will not be given, then we will put x is equals to a in the given function. But it is given to us, the value is 1 when x is equals to a, right? So this way we will prove the continuity. Next question, exactly same way. Now, for left hand limit, that means when x will be less than 1, we will take f of x plus 2. And for right hand limit, that means x greater than 1, we will be taking x minus 2. Earlier, the function was same only whether we are considering left hand limit or we are considering right hand limit. But now the only difference will be the value of the function will change. That means we are given f of x is equals to x plus 2 if x is less than 1. And f of x is equals to x minus 2 if x is greater than 1. We have to check the continuity at x is equals to 1. Right? So we will be, if we are taking 1 as a point and h a very small number, very small, that it approaches to 0. It is near to 0. It is 0.00000001, right? It will be a very small number. But still, if we are, we will be subtracting h from 1 on the number line, 1 minus h will lie on the left of 1. Right, and it is not equal to 1 because whatever the number h is, even if it is very small, we have subtracted it from 1. Therefore, now whatever the point will be, it will be less than 1. Whatever the point it will be less than 1. Therefore, for the left hand limit, our function will be x less than 1. Same way, when we will be adding h to 1, now whatever the number will be, it will be greater than 1. Therefore, the function will be x greater than 1. Right? So, we will be starting with left hand limit. So, left hand limit, we will be taking limit h is tending to 0 negative f of the point is 1, so we will be taking 1 minus h. It is equals to limit h is tending to 0 negative. What the function is? X plus 2. So we will replace x in f of x, x plus 2. We will replace x with 1 minus h. So we will be having 1 minus h plus 2. Right? 1 plus 2, 3. So it is limit h is tending to 0 negative 3 minus h. Now apply the limit. So we will apply the limit here. Here we are. And we will solve. We are having limit h is tending to 0 negative 3 minus h. Limit h is tending to 0 negative 3 minus h. Apply the limit means put h is equals to 0. So we will be getting 3 minus 0 is equals to 3. So our left hand limit is equals to 3. Now we will be calculating right hand limit. Right hand limit, we will be taking limit h is tending to 0 positive f of 1 plus h is equals to limit h is tending to 0 positive. Now we will be taking the function f of x is equals to x minus 2, because 1 plus h means the value of the point is slightly greater than 1. So when x is greater than 1, we are taking the function f of x is x minus 2. That means replace x with the 1 plus h. So it will be 1 plus h minus 2. So it will be 1 plus h minus 2, which is equals to limit h is tending to 0 positive h minus 1. Apply the limit, that means put h is equals to 0. So the value of the function will be minus 1. So when we are taking 1 minus h and the function is x plus 2, the return is 3. When we are taking 1 plus h and we are substituting the value, the return is minus 1. And also value of the function f of 1 at x is equals to 1, the value of the function is 0. Also f of 1 is equals to 0. So left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit, which is further not equal to the value of the function. Therefore the function is discontinuous at x is equals to 1. Therefore the function is discontinuous at x is equals to 1. Right? For x less than 1, otherwise this function is, for all the values which are less than 1, the function is continuous, because x plus 2 is a polynomial and every polynomial is a continuous function. For x greater than 1, all the values which are greater than 1, the function x minus 2 will be continuous, because x minus 2 is also a polynomial and a polynomial function is continuous. But when we will talk about the point x is equals to 1, we have checked left hand limit, right hand limit and the value of the function. The three values are not equal, therefore the function is discontinuous, right? Same way we will prove each and every question by taking left hand limit and right hand limit. But still there will be some question where this limits will not be applicable directly, then we will be using some properties. So we will be using algebra of continuous functions to prove the continuity wherever required. So what is this? Suppose f and g be two real functions continuous at a real number c. Then if f is a continuous function, g is a continuous function, then f plus g, that means sum of two continuous function, is also continuous. F plus g is continuous at that point. If f and g are continuous at a real number c, then their difference f minus g is also continuous at x is equals to c. If two functions are continuous, then their multiplication f into g is also continuous at that point. If two functions are continuous, then their difference f upon g is also continuous at that point. So how we will use this property? Suppose a function fx is given to you. Prove that sin x plus cos x is continuous, right? At every point. So you will take sin x as function gx, cos x as function hx. Then you will prove that sin x is continuous function, and you will prove that cos x is continuous function, right? Then you will apply the property, since sum of two continuous function is also continuous, therefore sin x plus cos x, which becomes fx, is also a continuous function. This type of question can come to you. Like this is fourth property, same way difference can come, right? Any question can come to you. Like for fourth property, I'm taking the example of tangent x. Suppose that the question is prove that tangent x is a continuous function. So the easy way, write tangent x is equals to sin x upon cos x. So prove that sin x is a continuous function and cos x is a continuous function. Then apply fourth property, that the difference of the two, when we will divide sin x upon cos x, then the division of the two is also continuous, right? Therefore, tangent x is equals to sin x upon cos x is also continuous function. This way we will be using these properties, right? So now we have to discuss the continuity of sine function, right? This question we will be doing. Then again we have question, prove that the function fx is defined by fx is equal to tangent x is a continuous function. So what we will do, we will write tangent x is equals to sine x upon cos x. So we will prove that sine x is continuous, cos x is continuous, and after that the division of the two function is continuous by the property, therefore tangent x is continuous. Next property we will be doing, suppose f and g are a real valued function such that f of g is defined at c. Right, f and g are two real valued function, and f of g, we had done f of g is f in the bracket g of x, it is a composition, right? It is defined at point c. Now what we are saying, if g is continuous and c, and if f is continuous at g of c, then f of g is continuous at c. Right, if g will be continuous at point c and f is continuous at g of c, g is continuous at c and f is continuous at g of c, now it will be g of c and f is continuous at g of c, then f of g is continuous at c. This is one another theorem which we will use in the questions. For example, we are taking show that the function defined by f of x is equals to sine in the bracket x square is a continuous function, right? sine in the bracket x square. We know the continuity of sine x, right? We will prove it also that sine x is a continuous function, but we have to prove the continuity of sine in the bracket x square. So we will be applying this composition f of g to prove that sine of x square is a continuous function, right? So how we will be doing that? Observe that the function is defined for every real number, right? The sine function is defined for every real number. The function f may be thought of a composition g of h of two functions g and h. Okay, so now what we will be doing, we are taking f of x is a composition g of h, g in the bracket h of x we are taking, where g of x is equals to sine x, we will take assume it, and h of x is equals to x square. G of x we are assuming, it is not, we are only to prove that sine of x square is continuous. So we are taking that, let g of x is sine x and h of x is x square. Then we will prove that if these two functions are continuous, then their composition will also be continuous, right? Now g in the bracket h of x, we what it will be, g is sine x and h means x square, so in place of x we will be writing x square. This we had done in the composition, how to find g of h if g and h are two functions, right? So if I'm taking gx is equals to sine x, hx is equals to sine x square only, that means g of hx will be sine x square, which is our given function. Now my task is to prove that sine x is continuous, x square is continuous. If I have proved that sine x is continuous, x square is continuous, then by this theorem, their composition g of h will also be continuous, right? So the function we are taking f may be thought of composition of two g of h. We are taking f of x as a composition g of h of two functions g and h, where g of x is sine x and h of x is x square. Now we will prove that here, okay? So we will prove that sine x is a continuous function, and we can write x square is a polynomial and it is a continuous function, or otherwise you can also prove that x square is continuous. Therefore, by the theorem that if f and g are two continuous function, their composition will also be continuous, g of x. Hanji?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes. Can we use graphs to show like they are continuous? We can draw the graph of sine x and x square.
Yes, we can draw the graph, but it will be additional, solution only. You have to prove it by taking limits only. Mathematically, you have to show the proof. We will prove it. How the sine x is continuous, we will prove it. Okay. In the previous question, we will prove it. Graphs are helpful because it is easy to understand and we can see the continuity graphically also, right? Whenever we need not to lift pen while drawing a graph, then we say that graphically the function is continuous. So from sine x graph and cos x graph, it is clear that the two functions are continuous, but mathematically we will be proving it, right? Clear? So we will prove it. We will prove it actually that sine x is a continuous function, right? So, but the proof we will be doing tomorrow. Today I planned of the two theorems I wanted to discuss with you. right? The first is algebra of the functions and the second is composition of the functions. Now, how to prove that the sine x is continuous, cos x is continuous and tangent x is continuous? We will discuss the continuity of these trigonometric functions tomorrow. Okay? So, here in this question, we will prove that sine x is continuous, right? We will not write that since sine x is continuous, we will actually prove. When I will show the proof here, then we will do the proof in this question also. Okay? So, this is just a brief of how to use the composition. We are not solving the question. I am just briefing you how we are using the composition. Okay? So, in the next question also, it is an example that how we are using the composition. Now, the next question is, show that the function f defined by f of x is equals to modulus 1 minus x plus mod of x, where x is any real number, is continuous. Now, there is modulus. And inside the modulus, there is 1 minus x plus modulus x again. We have to show that this function is continuous. Again, we will be using composition of the function to prove the continuity of this function, right? So, we are taking g of x as 1 minus x plus mod x, g of x as the bracketed value, the value inside the bracket only. This we are taking g of x, and h of x we are taking mod of x, right, for all real x. Then, their composition h of g will be h in the bracket g of x. H we are writing, and g of x, h of x is mod x, then x will be replaced with g of x. So we will be writing h of in the bracket g of x means 1 minus x plus mod x, and we will apply the function h of x, which is mod of 1 minus x plus mod x. This is the given function f of x. That means f of x we are writing h of g of x, which means h in the bracket g of x. We will prove that g of x is continuous, h is continuous. If we are successful in proving that the two functions are continuous, then we will be successful in proving that their composition is also continuous, right, by using the theorem. Now the only task is to prove that g of x and h is continuous. We have already done that mod of x is a continuous function. We have done previously, okay, in the continuity by taking left hand limit and right hand limit, that modulus of x is a continuous function, right? So you will prove it. You will prove it here first that mod of x is a continuous function. So we have seen that x is a continuous function, but we will actually prove it. And when we have proved that mod of x is continuous, so what is 1 minus x plus mod of x? This is sum of a constant function, x a single polynomial, right, and mod of x. And g being a sum of a polynomial function and modulus function is continuous. So we need not to prove g. When we have proved that, once we have proved that h is continuous, we can write that g is the sum of a polynomial. 1 minus x is a polynomial, right? And the sum of two continuous function is continuous. So we can write that 1 minus x plus mod x is continuous. And therefore, since the composition of two continuous function is continuous, therefore f being a composite of two continuous function is continuous, right? This is how we will be using composition. But actually, in order to show the solution, we will solve it completely. After writing composition, we will also prove that h is continuous. After proving h is continuous, we will be writing that 1 minus x is a polynomial and every polynomial is a continuous function. And sum of mod of x is continuous, we have already proved. Sum of two continuous function is continuous, we have done in the property, right? F plus g is continuous. Therefore, 1 minus x plus mod of x is continuous. Since h is continuous, g is continuous, and the composite of two functions is continuous, therefore f of x is continuous, right? Now, how to prove, how to write the complete solution, this we will be doing tomorrow, okay? And tomorrow we will finish this chapter, continuity also. Tomorrow will be the last day for continuity. No, sorry, now Tuesday. Monday, test of chapter functions, and Tuesday, we will be completing the chapter continuity. Okay, so in between you will be having enough time, you can practice the questions, right? Any doubt you can ask.